Bible said, be ye ready at all times. And I think I made a mistake when I told the pastor I always try to keep my sermon in the pocket just in case. And there was one of these just in case. It was a quick just in case, but I thank God that he allowed me to bring a word today. Today is troubling times because we don't know who the next president is going to be. I was telling Van Chambers this morning in Sunday school, it don't make no difference if Hillary Clinton get in office or Donald Trump get in office. God is still on the throne. And if economics turn bad, that doesn't mean a thing because God's going to take care of his people. But Prophet David said he has never seen the righteous forsaken, nor beg for bread. All right. And I'm telling you, God will bring you through anything. It don't make no difference who's in or who's out. God is always watching out for his saints. That's going to be a little bit of my topic today. If you turn to the Old Testament book of Amos, chapter 8. And then we're going to go to a New Testament, and I'll give you the title of what we'll be speaking on today. Amos chapter 8, verse 11. When you have it, say, I got it. Amos chapter 8, verse 11. Not too many people like to go to them small prophets, but I'm telling you, those small prophets is like small blessings that God gives. They might be small in package, but they are dynamite once you open them. Amos chapter 8, verse 11, and it reads, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor of thirst for water, but of the hearing of the word of the Lord. That's very important. If you will, now turn to the New Testament book of John, chapter 6. John, chapter 6, and we're going to begin at verse 51. In the Old Testament, the Lord just told us he's going to send a famine, but it ain't going to be for the thirst of food and water, but it's going to be a thirst, a hunger for the word of God. John, chapter 5, verse 51 states, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which is given for the life of the world. May the Lord have a blessing to the reading of his word. Now, a lot of people will read those verses and miss what God has just said. He just said, in troubled times, during a famine, I got your back. He's going to take care of you when times get troubled. And you do know what a famine is. A famine brings destruction. But today, God has good news for a famine. Because if most people say, well, God told me a famine's coming, and if you're not in God, the first thing they'll tell you to do, you better go down to Walmart, get as much water as you can. You better go to Piggly Wiggly and get as many pieces of bread or food that you can. Stock it up, because famine's coming. Well, God has a famine where you don't need to stock up on bread and water, but the word of God. Because if you get God, he'll send you the bread and the water that you need to stay alive. Jesus said, if you eat of this bread, you'll live forever. Amen. So why stock up? Now, a lot of people say, well, no, Scuba, that's in the spirit, but we're in the flesh. Now, if you're in the spirit, God will send you the bread and the water, and you won't even have to lift a hand that you must get. Amen. That's how God take care of it. So it don't make no difference who's in the White House. God is the house. Because there's bread and meat in my house. All right. He said in Malachi, he said, will a man rob God? No, a man can't rob God. All right. Because God got too much of it. You can't even pull it out. God got enough to give you and the robber if he needs to. See what I'm saying? God got your back. Why worry about who's in the White House? Think about who's in the big house. You want to get in the house with God. Because if you're outside his protection, then you need to go to Walmart. You need to go to Speaking of Wheat. And whoever else you need to get some bread and water from. Okay? If you ain't in God, go to Walmart. Go to Piggly Wiggly, okay? Because you're going to need them. And they ain't going to do that. See, they'll run out. But God will never run out. I'm sorry about that, Piggly Wiggly. But Winn Dixie, whoever it is. Okay? But God said he has a good family.
All right.
Because, see, only God can send a good or bad family. I want to get you educated on this here because see, everybody look at a family as bad. No food, no water. Okay. Sometimes God may have to put you on a spiritual diet called fasting for a little while. So that you can get into the Word of God, that you may hear what he's saying. Now, you might say, well, how can a family be good? Take for example. When Joseph's brothers tried to kill him, throwed him in a lion's pit, put the coat that his father Jacob had made for him, put blood on it, and said, oh, a lion killed him. Guess what God did? God allowed Joseph to go to Egypt and raise to the top of the authority down there in Egypt, and guess what God did? He sent a family. What did that family do? It brought a family together. Because when Jacob heard that it was corn in Egypt, he went to Egypt to get corn. But guess what God did? He sent him to Egypt to get his son.
All right.
The son that he loved so much. See, God will send a family in your life to bring you together.
All right.
Only God can send that kind of family to you. That's for good. Okay, you say, well, that's one incident. Well, let's look at another. Amalek and Naomi had to leave Jerusalem to go down to the land of Moabite to get food. Let me tell you something what God would do. God will send a famine in your life to bring you together. Just like he'll send a death in your family to bring you together.
All right.
He'll send a famine in your life to get you together. He had to send Amalek and Naomi down to the Moabite land to get Ruth. Why? Because Ruth was in the lineage of Jesus, whom the salvation of the world came by.
Amen.
You tell me God can't send a good family. And he'll take you through a bad family. Now, what you got to fear? Now, ain't God good? If he can take a nation and bring a whole world together, don't you think he can bring you and I together? And he'll do it with a family. And let me tell you something else what God will do with a family. He will shut down a meal on your job and send you somewhere else for you to be a blessing to somebody else.
All right.
You think that little job you got is forever? No. God can shut down. I know what I'm talking about. I worked at Scott for 25 years. People say, Scott ain't going nowhere. That Scott going to be there with you. Not only did he shut the plant down, he took the name off the wall.
Amen.
You tell me God ain't good.
All right.
And let me tell you something. I'm talking about personal testimony now. Me and another guy, you know Mike Williams used to come here, him and his wife too. Me and him were working there together. When they announced they were going to shut the plant down, everybody was running. What's going to do next? What's going to happen to us now? What are we going to do? Me and him started witnessing to people about how to get their life together. We weren't even worried about what we do. We were so dumb about doing God's work. Guess what God did for us? I'm talking about personal testimony now. We walk out the meal, don't know where we're going to get our next job. Guess what God did? He allowed us to get severance pay, good severance pay, sent us to school, and got paid going to school, and got unemployed And when we got out of school, we walked right into another day.
All right. All right.
Now you tell me God ain't good. God will send a family, even in the form of a job move. Sometimes he needs to move you somewhere to get to where you can be a blessing to others.
That's right, man.
If you don't believe, ask Trina. Trina, I thought Trina was a member all the time in this church. Mm-hmm. When we was over there off of Wilson Avenue, I thought she was a member. But God sent her there so that she can work, and God can work through Elder and Sharon and Mother Carter there for the helper.
Right now.
Amen. God, and guess what he did? He got us on Wilson Avenue too.
Amen.
God can work in your life when you don't even know he's working for your good. See, I thought I was going to be a scattered retirement scattered. Better retirement, got a retirement and build another retirement. You tell me God ain't good.
Amen.
God will send a family in your life to bless you after the family that went through.
All right.
Now you tell me God ain't good.
Yes,
ain't he good?
Yes, he is.
Brother Carl, he will send a family to your life to let your leg hurt and then let you walk right.
That's right.
Thank you.
That's right.
See, God knows how to send a good family. Now let me bring it to today's world. Sure. God will allow a family in your house where you won't have peace and joy. And then remove the other one out.
All right, now.
Am I right? Am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
Let me tell you something. God knows how to send a family.
All right.
So that you may have abundance after the left.
All right.
Don't tell me. I don't know what I'm talking about. Read your Bible. And if you don't read your Bible, read your own life.
Uh-huh.
Because when you used to went through something, God brought you through it, didn't he?
Yeah.
God has put some families in your life so that you may reap the blessings from the family that has been in your life.
Right.
You tell me God ain't good.
No.
Ain't God good?
God good?
Look what he did to the church the other day. They were in bondage, in slavery. And he brought them out and gave a land flowing with milk and honey. Didn't he do it for you? You right here in America was in bondage and slavery, and now you sitting in the White House.
Right.
You tell me God ain't good. The hands that picked cotton picked the president of the most powerful country in the world. You tell me God ain't good. He would take care of you when they said, no, a black man in the White House? Yes. A black man in the White House.
That's right.
It's shocking. Oh, don't tell me, because some of them clueless probably shot themselves and you just don't know
about it. That's right.
I guarantee. Ain't no way I'm going to be up on that black man, but God will let it be.
That's right.
See, that's what I like about God. God calls those things that do not exist as though they do. And when he calls them, they exist.
Amen. That's right.
Now you tell me, why are you worried about who's in the White House? God got your back.
That's right.
If there's a family in your life, you might have a patient that you might have been with for a long time. God will move that patient right out of the way and bless you with enough. Now you tell me God ain't good. Look at things that's in your life right now. And look at the goodness. You went through some troubles. But when you went through them, look at the sunshine that God brought in your life.
Amen.
Don't you know what a family do? It clear out the clutter that's in your life. Just like a hurricane. A hurricane takes all the mosquitoes out, the ones that have been biting you, and those mosquitoes could be close friends. Could be your best buddy. You see what I'm talking about? Could be a family member. God will them out. Or if you don't, he might change it, just like a hurricane can change things around. They ain't where they used to be. God can do that. See, there's a good family, and then there's a bad family. Because when I read the definition of family, it said crop failure, depopulation, government policy. But let me tell you something, Jesus is a government. He
say, I am that bread of life. And if you eat of me, you will what? Never die.
All right.
So what you worried about?
When I thought about that, I said, now, God, you know you had to set this thing up for Pastor Carl to call me at the last minute. I didn't even study for this lesson. I did. I was wondering why God put me on this topic. And here's the reason. There's going to be some trouble coming into this country. Some policies are going to happen. And there's going to be a famine in the land. But God always tells his people ahead of time before it happens. Now, the reason why he tells you ahead of time is not to scare you, but to encourage you. Don't worry, I got your back. Maybe that should have been a child, but that's God. Don't worry, God got your back. Even if you lose your job, he got your back. If you run out of money, he got your back. If you run out of physical food, he got your back. That's the message of the lesson today. God got your back. There's a famine in the land, but God is greater than the famine. He will send a good famine, and he will send a bad famine. You need to know the difference between the good one and the bad one. See, that was a bad famine in the land when the woman had an issue of blood. But when Jesus came, the bread of life, that issue of blood had to go.
Amen.
That was a man with a withered hand. There was a famine in the land. But when Jesus came, the withered hand had to go. What do you mean by that? A withered hand. Don't be a dry bone. You know what I mean by dry bone? You always into somebody else's business and making somebody else feel. Don't you be a spiritual person yourself. Let the Lord flow in other people's life through your life.
Oh,
and let them see the goodness and the plentifulness that's in you in Christ Jesus. Because Jesus said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. If he was watered in for them in the wilderness, he's watering for us today. And he'll be water for us tomorrow. So why are you worried? That's the message today. I'm hoping y'all get it. Why worry? God got your back. Family can come and family can go. But God is always on the ground. He sits high and he looks low. And if you believe in him, you'll be all right. Now I'm going to close with this. Spiritual famine is just as bad as a physical famine if you let it. What do I mean? Just like God can use a famine to bring people together, he can use a famine to separate you apart. What was one of the Ten Commandments? Do not cover thy neighbor, nor thy neighbor's wife, nor his ox, nor his ass. Stay out of folks' business. And you want to have a famine in your land. Are you getting this? You see what I'm saying? God said, if you follow what I said you, you'll have everything you need and you won't come last.
Amen.
If you have a spiritual famine in your life, get on your knees, go to God, say, Lord, feed me.
All right.
That's what eating of the bread of the Lord is. Not a third, not a bread, but the true bread. Get the word of God. Excuse me. Lastly, when God moves things in your life, Sharon, give you somebody else, or maybe give you a better job or raise on your job, always thank God. Give him the thanks. Blessings go when praises go up, blessings come down.
Amen.
Always acknowledge him. Don't think your smarts did. Going to pick a wiggle ain't gonna get it. You can go to Piggly Wiggly and get all the piggy and blood pressure medicine to go with it. You can go to Walmart and get all the water, and on your way home you can have a wreck and spill all your water out your car that you got from Walmart. And you better thank God.
That's right, that's right.
You understand what I'm saying? This is the message. God got your back. Don't worry about trouble times coming. Because James said trouble is coming.
Mm-hmm.
You can't stop trouble from coming. But God sure can make it better.
Amen.
So I'm saying to you today, trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not